I think the most rewarding was number one, if it became a hit. That was the goal, is to make it into something. But I think for me, working with the guys and the music we made and, you know, the harmony and the closeness of our personal lives as well as our musical life. And I think we each learned from each other. We'd known each other for quite a while. And just to know that music, you know, it was like, music does so many wonderful things. You know, when you hear a song, be it a miracle song or whatever other artists may be singing or playing the music, it has its own way of weaving itself into the core of your heart. The heartstrings just like perk up and you just feel as though something is happening inside. You know, for me, when I hear music, but you probably don't know this, but we recorded, I'm not going to say more than any other artist, but we recorded all the time. That's why they have all these songs that have not been released, because we recorded so much. We'd be in the studio, and at that time, you didn't have to pay the way you have to pay today to go in the studio. You just sign up, sing your song, and we usually had it all together before we went into the studio, so it was just making adjustments and making it a little better than what had happened, because we would be singing in the car, backstage. Somebody had an idea, usually it was Smokey that came up with something, and he's like, what about this? And then we try it out, see what happened. And I feel that the Miracles, and I'm probably prejudiced when I make this next statement, is the fact that we just had like an unusual kind of way of connecting. In terms of when we did our harmony, it wasn't so difficult to make it happen. It's like one person could start off and maybe Pete could say something, say, Claude, what about that or something, and everybody would just blend. It was sort of like a natural blend. And that's the one thing I really do miss, is being able to get with them and just, you know, just start it up, sing.